Indira Gandhi National Centre for the Arts, IGNCA, is an autonomous trust set up by the Government of India under the Ministry of Culture. As a premier research institute, it comprehends the arts not as finished products, but views them against the background of an Indian holistic worldview within a socio-cultural context. Through diverse programs of research, publication, training, creative activities, and performance, IGNCA seeks to place the arts within the context of the natural and human environment.
Indira Gandhi National Centre for the Arts is one of the biggest art repositories in India, and it caters the need of the entire South Asian region where we could find the Indian influence. From ancient to modern, from classical to folk, every study is being undertaken in this institution. We look after architecture, we look after sculpture, we look after paintings, we look after textiles, we look after scripts, manuscripts. All these studies are being undertaken at the IGNCA.
IGNCA has a trust which meets regularly to give general directions about the centre's work. The trust comprises of eminent scholars, artists, intellectuals and academicians. The executive committee, drawn from among the trustees, functions under a chairman.
Indira Gandhi Rashtriya Kala Kendra is a kala aur sanskriti ke liye samarpit sanstha hai. Kala aur sanskriti ka kaam hai samaj mein chetana ka vistar karna.
The Indira Gandhi National Centre for the Arts was constituted and registered at New Delhi on 24th March, 1987. The work of the centre is carried out through different divisions of the organisation, with the member secretary as the executive head of both academic and administrative divisions.
IGNCA works under several divisions. Initially, there were five divisions conceived for the IGNCA. One was the Kala Nidhi division, which was the biggest reference library for art and culture in India. Today, we have more than 2.5 lakhs of books and reference material. And in addition to this, we also have some of the rarest of rare books here at the Kala Nidhi division.
Subjects covered are archaeology, philosophy, religion and ritual studies, history and anthropology, art and literature, as well as folk and community studies.
We also have a very good collection of manuscripts through which our scholars can do studies on different aspects of Indian heritage. We also have some collections given by eminent persons like Hajari Prasad Divedi, Suniti Kumar Chatterjee, Dr. Kapila Vatsyayan, Dr. Devendra Swaroop.
The primary primary objective of Kalanidhi is acquisition, documentation, cataloging and dissemination of various source materials to users with the help of tools and techniques developed with the help of modern information and communication technology. The division has started a monthly book reading session in its reference library. Authors are invited to read and discuss their books with groups of scholars and members of the library.
Walk for 3 days and you will find a cave. Inside you will find the leopard skin on the ground. Sit on it, you may then find Lord Shiva.
The Kala Kosh division of IGNCA investigates intellectual traditions in their dimensions of multi-layers and multi-disciplines. As a research and publication division, it endeavors to place the arts within the integral framework of a cultural system, combining the textual with the oral, the visual and the oral. Around 175 titles have been published under three publication series, namely Kala Tattvakosh, the Kala Mool Shastra, and the Kala Samalochana. The Kala Samalochana program relates to publications on interpretation and analysis of secondary material. These are considered to be classics of art criticism. The series is made up of volumes of reprints of the pioneering scholars who have worked on Indian arts, such as Dr. Anand K. Kumaraswamy, etc.
Other than that, we also have some area studies being undertaken under the Kala Kosh division. One prominent area study is Southeast Asia, and another prominent area study is South Asia. We all know that South Asian region has a great influence of India in their art and culture.
Janapada Sampada division. The programs and activities of the Janapada Sampada division revolve around the rich and varied heritage of tribal, rural and other societies.
As we all know, that all which is known as the traditional or classical art has a relation with the folk and tribal or the local art form.
The division carries out its activities under different programs. Kshetra Sampada. Under this program, region and area-based studies are undertaken with an understanding that, over the course of history, certain areas or regions have developed into cultural centers, attracting people from all parts of India, providing space for motivated mobility and interaction. The spaces of IGNCA, their booking and supervision are the mandate of the Kaladarsana division.
Kaladarsana division undertakes various programs such as music concert, theatre performances, painting exhibitions, mural exhibitions and dance performances.
A music series in which artists are invited to present compositions not usually heard in concerts. Kaladarsana has its own series of programs. Among them are Sanjari,
Angels, where are you? My dear children, where are you?
And Kathakar, an international storytellers festival.
You think they don't exist, but they do. Listen.
An annual event that delights young and old alike.
Rani bolti hai mujhe mat daso mein raja ko chhod do.
Sun diye meri hai dubali itni.
Tanam the kehti.
तो उसने सी खाया, ए खाया, टी खाया और वो बिल्ली बन गई।
The Kaladarsana Division also undertakes documentation of music. It has a Masters of Hindustani Classical Music series, under which towering personalities of the genre are recorded for posterity. Vihangam, the IGNCA newsletter, is published by Publication Unit once in 2 months.
As we all know, dialogue has been an important tradition of Indian culture. And creative dialogue is the essence of our society. That is why we have started a Sanskriti Samvad Shrinkhala at the IGNCA.
Sanskriti Samvad Shrinkhala, a series of dialogues on a chosen topic in sync with Indian thought and philosophy.
Manushya apne jeevan mein shabdon ke alankaron se alankrit hokar kabhi vibhushit nahi ho sakta hai. Manushya apne jeevan mein vibhushit ho sakta hai to apni kritiyon ke madhyam se hi vibhushit ho sakta hai.
Mera janm jis kalkhand mein hua भारतीय स्वतंत्रता संग्राम का गांधी युद्ध।
संस्कृति और संवाद विषय पर आज बड़ी लंबी श्रृंखला में देख रहा हूं, मेरे सामने उन लोगों की है जिन्होंने भारत की संस्कृति को संजोया है, संरक्षित किया है।
सांस्कृतिक संवाद श्रृंखला यानी उन लोगों का को के जरिए जिनको हम सांस्कृतिक संवाद श्रृंखला में चुनते हैं, जिनको पात्र बनाते हैं, जिनको माध्यम बनाते हैं, उनके जरिए साहित्य पर, संस्कृति पर, समाज पर और भविष्य पर बातचीत होती है।
बिहार मूवमेंट के पहले जयप्रकाश नारायण को बारा चट्टी के जंगलों में, गांवों में, गांव-गांव घूमते हमने देखा।
After realizing the growth of the various art forms and the field art as such, we have also started a few more divisions at the IGNCA. One such division is Cultural Informatics Lab. This division deals with a convergence between the cultural studies and the information technology.
The Cultural Informatics Laboratory, CIL, is a multimedia research center that has been established with UNDP assistance to facilitate in making the millennia-old traditional systems of knowledge of India's rich past and vibrant present accessible in computer-generated multimedia. The Vedic Heritage Portal, initiated under the aegis of the Ministry of Culture, aims to communicate the message enshrined in the Vedas.
In the Rig Veda, numerous hymns, not to mention the Savitri, are attributed to this famous Purohita.
Under this division, we present multimedia forms such as Vrihadeshwara and Shravan Belgola, which we have recently produced.
Vrihadeshwara has been inscribed by UNESCO as a World Heritage Monument. The interactive DVD is the outcome of the IGNCA's research to understand the temple in its totality and not merely through the lens of an individual discipline.
We are also developing a National Cultural Audio-Visual Archives, which is one of its own kind in the entire Asian region. Other than Cultural Informatics Lab, we also have a division devoted for conservation work. As far as our tangible cultural heritage is concerned, paintings, murals, metalworks, all these conservation are being undertaken under this conservation division. It also deals with conservation related to manuscripts, which is very important.
Thank you. Adi Drishya Department. The Adi Drishya Department is visualized to study and experience the ancient world view through its different art forms, which relates to exploring artistic manifestations emanating from man's primary sense perceptions.
An art which is of prehistoric period. As we all know, we have cave paintings and rock paintings in India which are almost 10,000 years old. And that is why we are known as the oldest civilization of this world.
Rock art study is an emerging discipline in India. It is an integral part of our culture since it reflects its existence from time immemorial. It is a form of historical record that helps us to understand the development of artistic and cultural traditions and belief systems in various ecological niches in different chronological contexts.
रेड कलर में ये युद्ध करता हुआ ये पेंटिंग है यहाँ देखिए इनके हाथों में आला तलवार तीर चलाता हुआ ये पेंटिंग है 10,000 ईसा पूर्व का ये पेंटिंग है इसमें मतलब हिस्ट्री में इसको लिखा गया है
भारत विद्या प्रयोजना Recognizing the need to encompass and preserve the distributed fragments of Indian arts and culture, and to study the different aspects of Indic studies from the Indian viewpoint.
16th century is spreading of Hindu Buddha.
A long-term project titled Bharat Vidya Prayojana, BVP, has been initiated in the IGNCA.
Indology ka matlab hota hai ki आप हैं क्या हमारी पहचान क्या है हमारी अस्मिता क्या है इसको जानने की जो विद्या है वो इंडोलॉजी है
द फर्स्ट डेफिनेशन ऑफ धर्म इज लॉ सिविलाइज्ड लॉ
व्हाट इज वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग अबाउट दिस प्रैक्टिस ऑफ नियोग इज इट्स कॉम्प्लेक्सिटी इट इन्वॉल्वड एंड इंपैक्टेड मेन एंड वुमेन इन अ फेयरली कॉम्प्लेक्स वे व्हाई बिकॉज It could be exploitative and healing at the same time.
Under this program, the IGNCA aims to provide the right platform for creating a healthy discourse through the organization of special public lectures by eminent subject scholars.
If somebody wants to study Indian philosophy, he must know Advait, even within Advait, so many thinkers, then he must know Vishishtadvait, then he must know Abhinav Gupta, he must know so many, we must know Buddhism, within Buddhism, Madhyamika, so many kind other Buddhisms. So you can't just say Indian thought is one thing, you know.
Bharat Vidya hamari hai, aur hamari jo pahchan hai, wo hamari pahchan jo Sanskrit sahitya hai, ya Pali sahitya hai, ya Baudh sahitya hai, जो हमारा हमारा हमारी अपनी जो धरोहर है उससे हमको एक पहचान मिलती है और हम उससे जुड़े उसे जाने उसे समझें उस पर को पढ़ें उस पर रिसर्च करें
अदर देन दैट IGNCA has a Sutradhara division which deals with the administrative aspect of the institution
to nurture trained manpower in different fields of Indian art IGNCA has initiated one-year postgraduate diploma courses, such as Some new certificate courses have also been introduced. These are The Media Center has evolved from an audio-video unit. It has traveled from VHS format to the present digital formats and has become a research center for an audio-video collection which holds more than 12,000 hours of digital audio-video records. Media Center organizes film shows on the second and fourth Fridays of every month, at which films related to arts, culture, and lifestyle are shown. These shows are open to all. Another initiative by IGNCA is Balja.
I close my eyes and pray to you, my loving friends, and I know that you.
Under this program, workshops and film shows are organized.
Very good. He's a good inventor.
And school children are invited in large numbers for programs at IGNCA.
Bharat Mata Tumhe Pranam.
Aa chal ke tujhe main leke chalun.
The main focus of this program is to share the cultural heritage of our nation with school children. Focusing mainly on government schools and those from underprivileged sections. Narivad Prakalp. The Gender, Culture and Civilization Network of IGNCA seeks to create a space for discourse on women's culture, which is either airbrushed from history, marginalized, or distorted by misrepresentation of historical facts.
Without realizing the most of the women, without realizing they are the ones who are the carriers of our heritage and culture.
Purush mein bhi aap payenge ki matritv hota hai. Purush bhi poshak hota hai.
I want all men to support women and I want all women to support themselves. So let's first celebrate women.
The aim of Narivad Prakalp is to recover lost and suppressed voices of women, to revise and contextualize women's cultural resources and traditional knowledge systems as an integral element of gender studies, and to emphasize and reassess the key role women have played in the creation, preservation, and transmission of our cultural heritage.
Prachin Bharat mein mahila abla nahi thi. प्राचीन भारत की महिला रूढ़िवादी नहीं थी उसका प्रमाण अगर आप कुछ पन्नों में समेट सकें तो निश्चित रूप से करें और आज ये जो पुस्तिका आपने समर्पित की है लोगों को उसके लिए मैं विशेष रूप से धन्यवाद देती हूँ
शक्ति और शिव डोंट लाइक लॉन्ग सीरियस पीसेस इट्स अबाउट लाइफ इट्स अबाउट सृष्टि इट्स अबाउट क्रिएशन इट्स अबाउट जॉय इट्स अबाउट आनंद
IGNCA has opened its centers at some prominent places for paying attention to the cultural heritage of each region. These centers work as specialized centers for specific area studies.
We are developing IGNCA as the biggest resource as far as art and culture is concerned in the entire South Asian region.
Yani aane wale dinon mein Indira Gandhi Rashtriya Kala Kendra ke jo prabhag hain wo kya karenge kaise karenge aur unka lakshya kya hoga iske bare mein spashtata ho isliye hum logon ne vision document banwaya.
IGNCA continues to engage itself in research, documentation, and dissemination to preserve and present our great cultural heritage to our future generations.
Vismayo nama mayendra jala manush karmati shaya chitra pusta shilpa vidyati shayadibhir vibhavaihi samutpadyate.